Hey guys, so I've never posted here before because I've never had any interesting stories to tell. Although today my mother told me of something that happened to her while she was doing a grocery run. For some context, my mother is an older woman that works hard constantly. Despite her being in her mid-50s with arthritis, she is still able to do some serious exercise. She works as a delivery person, which makes her have to drive to multiple places while on a tight schedule every day, except for Sunday. She does this for up to 5-6 hours per day, 8 a.m. to 2 or 3 p.m., although sometimes she can have some serious pain from this job due to her arthritis, she still toughs it through the day. To the story. So, one day after she finished work, she went straight to do some shopping before returning home. In this shop, there are two lines, one for the baskets and one for the shopping carts / trolleys. My mother picked up a basket and went about her shopping. My mother gets her stuff and proceeds to head to the basket line. Bear in mind that there is a security guard walking around the general area. So my mother is waiting in the basket line, which is way shorter than the other line, as there were only a few people in her line and about 20 in the other. And when she's a few people away from scanning her items and leaving, she starts to hear some lady behind her ranting under her breath. My mother thinks nothing of it and continues to wait. The lady gets noticeably louder, and that's when my mother turns around to acknowledge her. She was your typical Karen, the haircut and all. She was surprised to find that this woman was talking to her. She was saying stuff along the lines of, "Ignorant woman, don't you have any respect?" By this point, my mother was pissed since she hadn't got the energy for an argument as she was too exhausted since it had been one of the busiest weeks at her job. She also noticed how she had a shopping cart, not a basket. "Excuse me, but I need to go in front of you because I have been waiting longer than you and I have mouths to feed," she said as soon as she noticed she had got my mother's attention. "What? Sorry, but I also have mouths to feed and I just want to get home," my mother said, not trying to start anything or aggravate her. "Look, lady, I've been in the shopping cart queue for 20 minutes. It's ridiculous, and you've only been here for like 5 minutes. You're just being ignorant now. Let me pass." The lady then stands there, expecting my mother to move. By this point, most of the people there were watching and some even laughing, which didn't go unnoticed by the security guard. Security guard walked over and said, "What's the problem? This woman has taken my space in the line and I need to have it back." She practically cries to the security guard. "I'm sorry, what? I've just been standing here and you came up to me asking to take my spot," my mother says, confused by her accusation. I suppose the security guard either didn't care or just didn't see the point in furthering the conflict and said, "Get over it and just let the woman pay for her thing. You're in the wrong line anyways." And with that, he walks away. After that, my mother just turned back around as if nothing happened. The Karen continued to argue and just wouldn't shut up. I suppose other people were feeling just as annoyed because someone from the opposite line shouted, "Shut up!" And with that, Karen, "Shut up!" At that point, my mother just started laughing. She paid and got out of there as fast as she could. She then told me the story where I posted it here, for all you amazing people to read. Just came back from the movies to watch the new Venom. As I'm sitting and waiting for the movie to start, close to 12 kids who are probably around 13 or 14 years old and their one chaperone come in. I hoped they wouldn't be an issue. I was wrong. As the movie starts, they're just talking like no one else is around. One guy loudly shushed them and they quieted down for maybe 2 seconds before continuing to talk and laugh. Another guy asks loudly for them to be quiet, and the mom yells back and tells him to be quiet. Another minute passes, and still, the kids are not being quiet. Now people are getting agitated and like half the room is shushing the kids. Mom still does nothing. And then one guy screams out, "Shut up!" This pisses the mom off, and she yells back to not swear in front of the children. He yells back to tell them to be quiet, and they start a screaming match. I'm now more entertained by this. Someone eventually brings in the manager, and now the mom is complaining about she's being harassed, but many people in the theater are backing up the dude who yelled at the mom. Eventually, they remove the mom and the kids. As the kids leave, they yell back, "Screw you," to the crowd, and we just clap. Movie was okay. For some backstory, I'm 26-year-old man and my friend is 25 years old. We both live in the USA. I recently bought a 2014 red Dodge Challenger STR8, and I live with my mom, she the best. On with the story. I live in a small neighborhood. About 20% of the people there own a muscle car, including me. So one day, my mom wants me to go buy some food at the supermarket, and I do just that. But I don't want to go alone, so I decided to call my friend if he wanted to go with me, and he said yes. So I go pick him up and head to the supermarket, which is 2 miles away. When we got there, I found a parking spot and headed to the supermarket. We were there for about 1 hour. When we were done, we both got to the car for the grocery in. But when we got to the car, we saw a woman and her son taking a look at my car. I think nothing of it. I thought they was just checking it out, but man, I was wrong. When I opened the trunk to put the grocery in, it was interrupted by none other than the entitled mother, and the conversation went like this. Entitled mother, excuse me, is this your car? My friend, yes, it is his car. Me, and do you need anything? Entitled mother, can my son drive it for a bit? What? No! Why? At this point, the entitled mother started to raise her voice. Me, your son is not old enough to drive. No, he is old enough to drive. Now, give me the key. My friend, no, lady. Why would I give you my key? Give me the key. It's not your car. Give me the key or I will call the cops. I look around and say, do it. My friend started laughing. Entitled, mother, call the cop. So we waited like 10 minutes for the car to arrive. The whole time, she's demanding for the key and says her kid deserves the car more than I do, and the cop finally arrives. Cop 1. What seems to be the problem here? I try to talk, but the entitled mother cuts me off. Officer, this man is trying to steal my car. Arrest him. Cop 1. Is this true? Me. No, officer. This is my car. I show the key to the officer. No. Arrest him, officer. He's lying. Cop 2, do you have any proof of this? Yes, officer. And I point at the Tesla. If you didn't know what a Tesla is an electric car. It has self-driving mode and have a camera on every side of it, so it records everything happens. Cop 1 was confused. Me, tell him what a Tesla is. So we waited for the Tesla owner while Karen is screaming the whole time. Eventually, the Tesla owner came and I asked him for the video. He was confused at first, but when he saw Karen, he knew what I'm talking about. And he showed the video to the cop, and Karen's face went white as the cop watched the video, and she got arrested for attempted theft. Also, the whole time, her kid looked confused, poor kid, and the cops left with the kid and Karen. What a legend. So me and my friend just drove home laughing. My friend said, I will never forget that day. I have no idea what happened to Karen next. And that brings us to the end. I think my life was saved by a Tesla. Every car should have a built-in camera like this. This story happened a couple of years back in 2019 when I was still a minor. Just to classify, I am a type 1 diabetic, which makes my life a little challenging now and again. Let me set the scene. It was around 2, and I was feeling kind of hungry, so I went to Subway as I didn't really eat that much that day, but I wanted food, so I went to eat. As I ordered my sandwich, in walks Karen and her little child. I didn't think much of her, cause she looked tired and, like the rest of us, just wanted food, cause we all love food. But when the nice employee says they have ran out of turkey, the mother then went ballistic saying, "What? But that's the only thing my son will eat." "Sorry, miss, but we ran out of that and we'll be getting our order of all meats tomorrow. Sorry again." She then looks down at her son and says, "Sorry, sweetie, these people don't care about starving children." The kid looks up and says, "That's fine, Mom. Can I get ham?" The mother looks absolutely furious at her son and says, "No, I told you in the car you're getting turkey or nothing." The kid looks so sad and I just felt heartbroken for this kid and just fuming the mother. At this point, I look at the cashier and just say, "Could you add a cookie?" The girl at the register smiles and says, "Of course." And so I am sitting down, eating my sandwich when I see the mum and child leaving, and I run up to the boy who was just looking so sad with no sandwich and his mother walking out with a foot-long sub like, seriously, lady, not even a cookie. Anyway, I finally catch up to them and say, hey, no cookie, huh? Have mine. It's untouched. So, here, take it. The kid's face lights up. Really? His face just lights up, and right as he goes to take it, his mum pushes me back. No, we don't want your tainted cookie, lady. As she pushes me, I fall back, and my bag just spills my things on the floor. Her eyes darted to my insulin pen because the lid fell off, and she started to scream like she just got shot. Oh my God, she has drugs. Arrest her now. She has heroin. Oh, well, yes. This is a drug, but this is my insulin, lady. I need it to live. She's still screaming about this and that and saying that I tried to drug her son. At this point, the police have to show because of this delusional woman and have to take away while to get my stuff and my mental health back together. But long story short, she got banned and I heard she moved due to embarrassment and I never saw her again. So good for me, and I got a coupon at that Subway, so I think it was a win-win for me. Me and my friends talk about this all the time when we go past that Subway, when we go back to that town. Back in February, I made a post about my youngest son's grandma, entitled Mother-in-Law, and her husband taking me to court for visitation for my son. She wanted, and still wants, 1 week per month visitation. I got a call from her attorney's office today, and the person I spoke with explained that not only does my mother-in-law want 1 week per month, but also wants 2 weekends and alternating holidays. I said no, and was told that the judge is going to be expecting a written agreement settled out of court by tomorrow. I disagreed to the entire proposal. I didn't want to sound close-minded or stubborn, but I explained that I had recently received custody of my 3 older kids and my kids have a strong bond with their brother. They've been away since my son was born and they just barely moved back. I also mentioned that I am moving back to my hometown, which is 4 hours away from where I live now. My youngest may have family here, but my older kids and I don't have a support system, so I feel it's best we move closer to family that I've actually been raised around, my mom, grandma, auntie, and sibling. I messaged my mother-in-law and let her know what my counteroffer would be, 1 week per month during summer vacation. 1 weekend per month. Holiday visits are to be done either the weekend before the holiday or the weekend after. Of course, with her being the way she is, her response was, that's not fair. Then she said that if I'm moving, then she's just going to request 2 week per month visitation. She then told me we'll just have to settle in court. I stuck to my guns and told her that this was my counteroffer. She's been a control freak since before my son was even born. And may I mention, once again, she's the grandparent, not the parent. Her son, my son's father, is in prison for a violent crime. Her husband is also a part of the case because he's one of the petitioners as well. But I can't help but believe that she's pulling all the strings and she wears the pants in the relationship. I have not ever refused her visits with my son. She has always been able to see him whenever she wants. We live in the same town, for now. This proposal was brought up before my plans to move, by the way. Thanks for listening.